In this video we will take a closer look at Party Heal Buff tab in the Adrenaline Bot interface. The settings of this tab determine how your bot and its pets will behave toward party members while farming. Rebuff the party, check HP MP level and healer restore mana under certain conditions, check the presence of debuffs on party members, and remove them if the character has a suitable skill for this. You can also set up out of party buff and heal in this tab. We will discuss details on how to do it at the end of this video. The first thing we see is a table that displays a list of skills, items, and pet skills, as well as their settings. In the first column, the name, in the second, various conditions, in the third, the priority of use, in the fourth, targets to which the skill will be applied. Below the table are the settings for the selected element in the table, as well as buttons for adding and removing list elements. If you suddenly want to change the order of the element in the list, just drag it with the mouse. Let's consider the available settings. Type. In this drop-down list, we choose what positive effects the bot will use. A character's skill, an item or a pet's skill. Items are useful if you need, for example, to customize resurrection of allies with scrolls of resurrection. And with the help of pet skills, you can apply summons party buffs to your party, for example, Gift of Seraphim. Name. After choosing the type, select the required skill, item or pet skill from this drop-down list. For ease of search, you can start entering the desired name. Please note that the bot has its own database, and the names may not be the same with those you see in the game. Target. Using this button, you can customize the nicknames of the characters to which the selected skills will be applied. By default, the skills in the list are applied to all party members. By specifying the nicknames, you can, for example, configure that the Berserker Spirit buffs on everyone except the tank. We strongly recommend not to leave the use of skills for the whole group, but to set it up individually for each skill if you are exping in a party with randoms. Otherwise, it may result in your bot being detected. Interval is the minimum time that must elapse between attempts to apply the selected buff, i.e. the check of other conditions will be performed once in the number of seconds specified here. To use. Here you can configure the time that the bot will wait after all the conditions are met and before the buff is directly used, i.e. if a buff is expired, the bot won't immediately apply it back, but will wait for few seconds so as not to raise unnecessary suspicion. Moreover, the bot will once again check all the necessary conditions before using the buff. This function works only if you have enabled interval. For example, you have two healers in your party who can resurrect. You can set up interval 5 seconds to use earn resurrection skill for one of the bots so that they don't write asynchronously res the party members. The logic will work as follows. The main healer will instantly resurrect the party members, and after 5 seconds the condition, target dead, for second healer to use resurrection will no longer be met. But if the first healer has cooldown and cannot resurrect dead party member within 5 seconds, the second healer will do it for him. Combo. This option should be used when you need to rebuff several buffs at once. All buffs marked with this checkbox are separated in a different group and will be rebuffed only when the conditions for all elements are met simultaneously. If at least one of the combo buffs does not meet the conditions for use, the bot will not be rebuffed by them at all. This function is useful for dances and songs. For example, you can set up so that dances are buffed only when all dances expire, but at the same time only after some specific songs. Stand up. If this option is active, the bot will interrupt the regen and stand up to use the selected skill or item. This is useful for servers where the bots really need to sit down and regen to restore HP and MP. You can find more information on how to set up automatic rest of the character in our other video dedicated to the self-heal tab. Target in fight, or we in fight. If this option is enabled, the bot will use the selected buff, including during being in combat, i.e. while we, and, or our target are attacked by aggressive mobs, otherwise, only when no one is attacking us, and, or our target. If no buffs, or if have debuffs. This is one of the most important settings. With its help, the bot checks the presence of the specified positive or negative effects on party members, as well as their remaining time and level. These options are opposite in meaning, so you can choose only one of them for a specific buff. Let's take a closer look at them. By choosing the If No Buffs option, we need to indicate the name of the buff or debuff in the field below, the presence of which will be checked, and if it is absent on party member, the bot will use the selected skill. For ease of setting, you can double-click on the field to bring up a list of effects applied on character, as well as its skills. In addition to this, you can add a condition check for the remaining buff time or its level. For example, you can buff Might from Prophet only if there is neither the Might itself, nor the buff with the same effects from other classes or herbs. To make the rebuff happen a bit beforehand, set a condition less than 60 seconds for the remaining time. Also, we set the condition less than 3 for level, so that the Might will be buffed on top of buffs of others if our effect is stronger. By choosing the If Have Debuffs option, we need to indicate the name of the effect in the field below, in the presence of which the bot will use the selected skill. Thus, for example, you can configure Cleanse skill and enter a list of debuffs separated by semicolons in the field below. Or you can set up Shylin Knight to use the icon Spirit of Shylin only when level 3 of Pain of Shylin is achieved. For ease of setting, double-click to open a list of debuffs we, or our allies, are currently affected by, and select the ones you need among them. Please note that in case of debuffs, the conditions for the remaining time and level begin to work on the AND principle, not OR as it was in case of buffs. Let's consider an example. We have Purify skill, we want it to be used if ally is affected by one of the listed debuffs. And only if the debuff time is more than 3 seconds. Conditions. Here you can set up to 3 different conditions for the use of the selected skill, item, or pet skill. Please note that the first condition is set up for your character, and the second and third, for your party members. The type of condition is selected on the left, and on the right, the value to be compared with. For different types of conditions, you need to enter different values here. For example, all sorts of conditions for HP, MP, CP, either percent or absolute values are indicated here. There are also conditions where you don't need to specify any values at all, for example, checks for root, stun, death, etc. If you set up 2 or more conditions, they must be used simultaneously in order to use buffs. If you need a buff to be applied according to first condition or second, just make 2 buffs in the list and specify 1 condition for each. Be careful when you setting the conditions. They must not contradict each other. Otherwise, buffs will not be used at all. Radius. Here we can set up minimum and maximum distance to the party member at which the selected skill will be used. The distance is usually set automatically according to the radius of configured skill. Use shot. If you need to save shots, this option allows you to flexibly adjust the conditions when and what shots should be used and when they shouldn't be used at all. For example, it can be adjusted so that shots are used only with skills that have long casting time, or only if we or our party have low HP, or lots of mobs are attacking us. The main thing is not to forget to disable the option turn on existing shots automatically on the miscellaneous tab. Priority. This scale is responsible for the sequence of using customized buffs and heal. To change the priority, you just need to drag slider up or down. The higher slider, the higher the priority. In addition, the order of buffs is influenced by the order in which they appear in the table, i.e. if 2 buffs have the same priority, the one that comes first in the list will be used first. Let's take a closer look at configuring off-party buff and heal. Out of party. This setting activates checks of all the necessary conditions for HP, MP, CP or buff time on the off-party characters. If this option is disabled, the check is performed only among party members or characters with specified nicknames. When we activate it, the bot will check all characters under its control, or only characters with specified nicknames, if they are configured. The characters that need to be buffed must be in the buffer's line of sight and must be loaded by the bot from the same PC. Party request, exiting in. This option should be activated if the selected skill requires a party for use, for example, Warcrier buffs or dances songs. Thus, before using the skill, the bot will request a party from party leader, accept it and then rebuff and leave the party. Also, these settings have a couple of nuances that you should know. If the selected skill has the out of party option activated, but there are no specified nicknames in target, the bot will automatically check all characters under its control and in the buffer's line of sight. This is done for ease of setting, so you don't have to constantly specify nicknames. If a skill has an active party request option, and the nicknames of the characters that need to be buffed are specified, but they are not party leader, the bot will find out who is their leader by himself and make a party request to him. For example, we have Blade Dancer, which is a party leader, Destroyer and an off-party Prophet, which should buff Berserker Spirit only on Destro. Blade Dancer and Destro are constantly in party, and Prophet will check the buff time on Destroyer, and when the time for the rebuff comes, will check if they are in the party now, and if he is a party leader. If he is in party, the bot will understand that Blade Dancer, controlled by bot, is a party leader, and will send a party request to him. If Destro is off party, Prophet will send a party request to him. If Destro is in a party with a character that is not under bot's control, then Prophet won't be able to rebuff him, i.e. it is very important for off-party buff to have party leader under our bot's control. Now you know everything about setting up party buff and heal in the Adrenaline Bot interface. If you want to know about the setting of other tabs, watch the video on our channel. And also subscribe and learn more about the capabilities of the Adrenaline Bot and scripts for it. You can buy a bot on our official website, adrenalinebot.com. If you have any questions, feel free to contact our technical support in Discord.